are back, and it is time to make some power. And I know you guys like that, because the last time we did this, it turned out to be one of the biggest videos on the channel so far. And in that video, we covered our entire Quadzilla Adrenaline tuner install with the custom iQuad tuning abilities. If you're unfamiliar with that product, it is the best and only custom tuning option you can put on your VP44 Cummins. And as you can see by my setup here, it is pretty dusty because I have been running this for about 30,000-ish miles now. Been all over the country with it. And before I was running an Edge comp box, and I can tell you this Quadzilla absolutely blows it out of the water. Now, this here is a 99 automatic that we installed on last time. So now we will be installing on Little Brother's 2001 that has the 5-speed manual in it. Here we have the nice new tuner. We got our main box. We have our stickers to place by each battery to tell you to unplug this box, meaning that big gray connector from right there anytime you mess with your batteries or jump the vehicle. We got, well, I'll drop it here. Stay. We got our fuel tap there. Not fuel tap, fuse box tap. For power, that's where this white and red wire goes in to your dash. We got various data sensors and map links right here. We will obviously show you that in the exact spot where we install. They have an optional EGT probe as well. I don't recall if there's already one on this truck or not. We'll have to get up there and look. And then we have, oh, I am dropping stuff. To finish it off, the iQuad unit, which is what is going to communicate with your cell phone and allow you to do the various custom tuning options. And then you've got some wiretaps and sensor holes and adapters and stuff in there. If that sounded or looked scary, don't worry about it. We will go over every single connection, exactly where it goes, and what we do and don't use, and all of that, so you can get it plugged right in. This is also just the hack job of a wiring install that whoever put this in there did. These janky wiring jobs are why second gens and other trucks are burning to the ground. Just stop doing it. Just install it right the first time and save you and everyone who ever has to touch it again the trouble. Alrighty, now this truck already had an EGT sensor, which means the new Quadzilla one will just fit right on there. If your truck does not already have an EGT sensor, then you can reference the video where we installed it on my truck. When you are drilling and tapping the manifold, you either want a second person that can hold a shop vac next to the hole while you're drilling it to suck in the little shavings. And you will also want to cover your drill bit in grease to help those stick. Or you cover it in grease and you let the truck run while you drill your hole. That way the air is forcing the metal bits out versus inside your manifold. Now, if you can't do either of those and you're doing it by yourself with like just the grease method and maybe a vacuum, I would recommend getting a little pen magnet so you can stick it down in the hole and fish it around just to get the last little bits of metal, because you don't want any of that going into. And the last note is you want to put it right in the middle of your two banks, so your three cylinders in the back and your three in the front will meet and give you a nice correct reading. So in our box, I believe what has happened is they sent us both map sensor connections. Because like, was it 98.5 through like 99 or 2000 is one style. I believe that style. That style? And then 2000 and up, I think, is that style? I don't remember. But either way, we're going to take one of these and go match it up with the truck and figure out which one it is. While he's matching that up, I do have to note If you just order directly from Quadzilla, like a brand new unit, they have you put in what year your truck is on the website. So you will only end up with one connector, so there won't be any questioning it. We picked this unit up a little bit different method. We didn't just order it right off the website, but we did get it from them. So I guess they just sent both. I went inside for about 15 minutes and he basically has everything plugged up. So we will go over it real quick. All right, so we're starting driver's side battery. This is where your quad will sit. So you got your big main plug. As you can see, we have power and ground going that way there. Power and ground, they will go to our battery. This red one is the constant 12 volt so that the tuner here will always save your settings. And then your turn on wire is going to be this white one with the red stripe, which goes in to your firewall through a grommet there.
All right, so that white and red wire that runs through the firewall gets plugged into this connector thing here with two 10 amp fuses that gets plugged into the number 9, which is for the engine.
And next up is going to be this one here, which runs along the firewall and plugs in right there to the EGT sensor. Then let's follow this one right here to go down
the fuel.
I can see it. Oh, there we go.
Yep, you can see me pulling on it.
Right in there. Down there. Now, this truck already came with a Fast Fuel Systems lift pump on it. So the fuel pressure fitting has already been cut and spliced into that main fuel line you saw us jiggling there. But that'll just come with a T-fitting. You take your two rubber hoses and push them onto the end. And then the sensor will just have a screw on there. And then your plug just snaps right in.
Yeah.
And then we also have the map sensors and whatnot back in there.
You can see the purple and green wires, the map sensors, and then there. So we got the map sensors in there, the pink and green, there's the one that goes into the block, the one that goes into the other connector that's in there, and then there is the pink and purple that goes down to that connector over there that I believe is the data link connector. And then the purple and pink ones get connected to the main Quadzilla unit there. You can see him jiggling.
And then our final connections. If you look in, you see that empty ring terminal I'm jiggling right there? That is going to be either for your transmission temperature, which this truck does not need because it's a 5-speed manual, or you can do your oil temperature sensor, and that screws into the top of your oil filter housing. But we aren't really too worried about that, so we just zip tied it up out of the way. And the last and most important connection, see that green wire there? That runs in to that other grayish wire, which goes right over in there and taps in to the VP44, which is under there. Since this truck did have a really old edge tuner already on it, someone has already moved the throttle position sensor and tapped the VP44 wire. Now, you can either go back to my video of installing this, where we had to do the wire tap, or if you just YouTube VP44 wire tap for a tuner, Thoroughbred Diesel has a really great video where they pull it off, they show you the exact wire, and make it easy peasy. If you don't want to go look up the video, you take off those three bolts, and then your throttle position sensor will lay over towards us. You're going to pull your intake horn off, and then right back there where that wire goes in, you're going to find two wires. Now, that wire that's on the top, that goes in to the VP44, that's the one you're going to want to splice into. But honestly, I would suggest just look up a video of someone tapping that wire real quick. Because the VP44 is expensive, and if you cut that wire in half, you're not going to be having a good day. But just look a video up and save yourself the trouble. Just kidding, not the last thing. This here is the last thing that plugs in right there. This is the iQuad that communicates with your phone. So now we just have to clean off this area with the alcohol wipe provided and get the Quadzilla unit stuck. Mount our iQuad unit on top. Plug our batteries in, plug our quad in, and it should be good to go. I hope that all makes some sense. It's a little more scatterbrained than I was thinking it would be, but I think you'll get it. Quad unit is mounted, batteries are hooked up. Stickers, once again, reminding you to always unplug that big gray connector before you unhook your batteries or jump the vehicle. Do not forget. You will fry the unit. Then you'll have to unplug the unit and drive a slow truck again while you send the unit back, pay money for it to get repaired, and all of that unfun nonsense. Now we're gonna get the custom tune for a stock turbo and injectors loaded up and go for a rip. When you're connecting to your quad, that is what you should see right there. I wasn't quick enough, but normally in the center of the screen here, it will say initializing when you first open it up. To load our custom tune, I went here, custom tuning, and then we labeled it HX35 with stock injectors. Say yes. That will load up in there. That's the initializing thing I told you about. It should do that every time when you load it up as well. Alrighty, so now you're good to go. You can either put your phone up somewhere and monitor all of your gauges here, or you cannot worry about it. And you can also change, I believe if we hold here, maybe not. Let's try this. I hardly mess with my app, so excuse my wandering around here. Won't this work? Okay, well, there's some way you can change all these gauges, so I will try and figure that out again and let you know before we close the video out. But for now, let's go. Let's see what she does. I forgot one important thing. We're going to go ahead and hop back in the app real quick. So under your menu here, we're going to go to sensor warnings, and we're going to turn every one of those off. Those are just fun killers. We don't need any of that. Oh, go back. Hold on. Just turn off. Gosh darn it. Turn off. Turn off. Turn off. What the heck? Oh my god. We'll get there.
It's a bigger phone. You're not used to it, probably.
I know. My little fingers don't know where to go. There we go. Settings off. I'm going to go back. Now let's go. So, you guys remember that fuel pump tap I was telling you we didn't have to do because somebody already did it? Well, after the truck didn't produce any extra smoke, which is not why we're out here really, but it is a sign if your tap is working or not, we took further investigation and whoever put the old crappy edge tuner on it tapped the wrong VP44 wire. So, we are going to have to correct that. So we will end up showing you those steps, and then we will try this again. We are now, it's the next morning, fixing our wire tap. That is the black wire that runs to the green wire from the quad that was attached there. Now, if you can see where the wire was cut, they attached it to the top set of wires, but they did it on the wire not closest to the block. And see the wire just above the one we cut, that's the one that the wire actually needs to be attached to, which we're going to use this here. It's the wire tap they give us. Let's see if I can get it apart here. Should have done this already. So this will come, yeah, spin it apart for me. So that comes apart, you slip your wire in that gray crack, and then tighten it on to there. And then the other end of the wire goes in the other end. And we, right there, will be nice and secure. And there you can see the old wire that was tapped. And then we have gone into the wire. Little focus. Stop doing that. Just above the other one. And we gave a little tug on the wire. And it is nice and secure in there. We definitely got it right this time.
Okay, we got it right this time. That was some smoke right there.
We're gonna let it warm up just a little more and then we'll get to ripping on it. He has to head off to work, but once he gets back, we're gonna take it back out and we're gonna set it down all the way to zero, get a 0 to 60 inside outside video, then turn it up on the tune, 0 to 60, all that good stuff, and give you an actual comparison as to how much faster it actually is, because sitting inside the truck taking a ride, it is night and day better. It was a total snail before, as all second gens start out, and now it can actually get out of its own way. All right, we have made it to our secure testing facility once again, and we have it on the default tune, and it is a manual, so things won't be too terribly consistent, but we'll give you a general idea on 0 to 60. All right, whenever you're ready over there. Make our lap back around to test again. We went from our default setting to our HX35 and stock injector tune, and now we will see what that one does. Alrighty, excuse the bumpiness, just is what it is. I got little arms. Alrighty, ready when you are. But that is, it's a night and day difference. Now I'm gonna have him come by in second, and I'm gonna have him hit the gas right before he gets before me. We'll do it in default and then tuned, and hopefully we can get an idea of how much harder it rips from the outside here. I stood too far away and then I didn't get to walk forward fast enough to catch the rest of that, but you heard it, and that should do the trick. Stand over here in the shade this time, maybe we can see better. Yeah, again, I don't know until looking back on it, but it's just, it's night and day more aggressive on the tune. It went the opposite way I wanted, camera. We're supposed to zoom out, not in. Still sounded good, though. I gotta say, his full 5-inch definitely beats my full 4-inch. For some reason, I let this silly old guy talk me out of a 5-inch. But, oh well. Now we're hood stacking it forever, probably, so. He did also say that he wants to give the hood stack a shot whenever my larger turbo comes in, and then I change out my pipe. So then we can just take the one that's on my truck and slap it right on his. Where we will leave off on little brother's truck for now. We do have a set of diesel auto power 150 horse injectors sitting there waiting for it for as soon as we get back from the Little People Nationals in Texas. That's gonna be down in Austin, which will also bring some of its own videos. So if you drop a like and a comment on what you liked in the video, that would be super duper helpful, and stay tuned for future videos.